I'd like to give you a quick tutorial on how to install a JCB package, or import is the right word really. Now, at the end of the day, you already have JCB on your system, so I'm not going to explain how we got to this point. But from here on further, there are two ways to get to the installing view. One is by clicking on this icon, and it'll take you there. The other one is going to Joomla Components, and there is a button up here that says Import JCB Packages, and that will take you to the same place. You'll see that there is a number of tabs here, and you can actually, if you're not interested in these two tabs, there's actually an option in the global options, where at this point we are controlling those tabs through this global switch that says Manage JCB Package Directories. You could say Show All, Show None, or manually select the repositories that you want to show. At the moment there are only these two, but there are reasons to expect that they might become more as we see, you know, this area becoming more active. Okay, so once you are on this page and you have yourself exported a JCB package, then this is where you can select it from your computer or from a directory or from a URL. And with these import methods, there is not a checksum validation feature in place. So you need to be sure of the integrity of that package. We cannot validate that package's integrity. And since if it's being selected from your desktop and you are in a, your local development environment, there should be no reasons for concern. If you're pulling it from an external source, then possibly you need to be more cautious. Whereas it, when it comes to the VDM packages and the JCB community packages, these are the areas where we are trying to add some layer of security to try and protect you and to ensure that the package area remains as stable as possible. And so there is ways for you to add your own JCB package to the community repository. Here is a tutorial to show you how to do that, and also explaining why we will do things the way we do them, because of the fact that everybody will then have access to that package in this area. You can then also now get free keys for the VDM packages. In the past, you had to pay for them, and we have decided in an initiative to sort of show all of you exactly how JCB can work and function. We have decided to give these packages away, asking you to follow a few steps in supporting us by forking, starring, or watching these packages in their specific repositories on GitHub. You're needing more guidance about this, you can just click on that link and it will show you exactly what you need to do. And once you've got the key for that specific package, you can come and select that package here. Obviously, it's only related to some of the packages at this point, which the first being the most prominent component builder itself. And so I would suspect that would be your first choice as well. And once you've selected the package, you simply can click on Get to have the package be taken from GitHub and brought to your developing environment. And in doing so, it will actually run a validation on the integrity of the package, because there are checksums in place. But you need to validate the checksum manually. And the way you do that is it will show you the checksum that was used to validate the package integrity. And since it's passed the validation, you know that this checksum is the one that you need to see if you open this link. So opening this link will also reveal a checksum, but at this time you will be seeing a verification by DigiCert, and it must be at least this part of the URL must be correct up to there. This will vary from package to package, but it should have the package name here, and this should correspond to the value that you see here. And that little bit of manual effort is all you need to do to be sure that the package that you have now got in your possession is the original authentic package that we have distributed. So at this point, you're all good to go. All you need now is to take the key that we have sent you and to add it here to the key area, like so. Now you need to make a choice whether you want to, if JCB already is installed on your system, maybe it's the second time you're doing this, then you might not want to merge, you might want to have it be like a clone, like a second instance of JCB. It will literally then create all the fields and all the views and all the linked concepts again. Whereas if you choose merge and there is a change in the package which is newer than the version you have, it will actually update that version. If you want to force it to update it, you will say yes up here. The force local update really only works if you've selected merge. Then there's also show all import information, which if it's the first time that you're importing a package, it might be ideal to check this to yes, because it will show you literally everything that it does, every field it adds, but it will not show you names, it'll show you ID, so a lot of it will be like, okay, that doesn't make sense to see anyway. But at the very bottom of the list, it shows you the files that it's moved, and this is what you need to see. You need to see the files that is moved into your system, especially if it's not a package that we are providing or someone else that has been sort of validated through the community, but it's someone that you've imported through a URL or through a package from your distributed package you received or from a directory, then you most certainly want to see all import info, because you want to make sure that what they told you is what you get. And that's what that little feature is all there about. Then there's also the component that is being imported should show here, the same as the one you saw before we got the package. Now, those of you that have used this area multiple times, you will know that you're actually able to add multiple components into one package. It's just because we at VDM are distributing one component at a time. That's why there's only one component in the package. But in the greater perspective, you can actually import a backup package right here. And that would be then everything that you have done. So in my case, all the components I've built are actually zipped in a backup package. And I can import all of those into JCB at once. At the moment, I've tested it up to at least 20 components, which is, it takes a while, but it actually gets there. Okay, so at this point, everything looks fine and you can click continue. This, depending on the size of the component or the size of the package, might take longer and shorter. And I would just suggest that you wait it out and take a sip of coffee or something. It does take a while because literally at this point, it is updating the IDs one at a time. So with every field, the IDs are being updated, with every view, and everywhere that ID in any other ID is being used anywhere across the component, everything is dynamically being updated during this process. And so as you can expect, it is a lot of compilation, a lot of algorithm, a lot of things happening under the hood, and therefore does take a little bit longer than you might expect because the IDs change. And the way we export the package is literally just taking a photocopy of the package as it is in the JCB where it was developed or where it resides. And when you import it, we now recreate and remap every ID to ensure that it remains functional, although basically all its identifiers have changed. Okay, so just wait, and in a moment it will show you that it's been successful. But it does take a while. Once it's done, you'll get this long list, especially if it was JCB which you've imported. I mean, it's a long list. It has over 1,000 fields, so you can anticipate a long scroll. I'm gonna grab this thing here and just drag it, and it goes and goes and goes, and it's huge. But there, very much at the bottom, you start seeing different things like the files, every little file that has been imported. And that's really helpful if you are importing a package from a developer which you do not know or you're not absolutely sure you can trust. then now you must check every one of these fields that they are legitimately related to this component and that it is actually what you anticipated or expected. And you can also therefore go look at these folders. They are all related to the custom folder at the moment as we scroll. And now here are some folders that are related to the administrator VDM compiler. Yes, this is in the compiler. So there's a lot of files for the compiler, Joomla 3, then for the helper. This little thing here is just like a spacer, really, by which we sort of create the string. And so there you get all the files that have been moved into place. And lo and behold, there is Component Builder, the fully mapped package in your system. And that's really as simple as it is to get the component that you need fully mapped into your system. And as you can see, all its views are correctly mapped in here. And if you open any of those views, you will again see that all its fields are also correctly mapped. And you do realize that every one of these fields, their IDs have changed. And even the fields, they again have field types. And even those might have changed, the field types itself. And so down to the very smallest detail, we've tried to make sure that every little thing all across the board is remapped and, you know, fixed so that your component is again fully active and stable, ready for further development. Okay, so that is the quick tutorial on how to import a JCB package into JCB. Thanks for watching.